What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I wanted to revisit something that I briefly went over in the last video, which is the Lat Lon tools. Okay, there's a plugin in QGIS that will let you manipulate all of your coordinate data. All right, so let's get into it. The first thing, let me show you how to get the Lat Lon plugin. I showed it in the last video, but since this video is specifically going towards it, I'll do it again in here. So we'll go to plugins. We'll go to manage and install plugins. And once we get here, we can make sure that we're either in the all tab or the not installed tab. And all we need to do is type in L-A-T. Once you type that in, hit the space bar, and Lat Lon Tools comes up automatically. This little button down here will say install if you do not have it already installed. And you can click that and you will be ready to follow along with the video. Okay, let's close. Now, before I get into this, I'm probably going to have to break these sections down into multiple videos. The first thing to cover is the copy display coordinate. So what in the world does this do? Well, it does exactly what the name says. What you're going to do is you're going to click on the button. And after you've clicked on the button, when you go into your canvas extent, you will see that your cursor changes to crosshairs. All right. So anywhere in the extent that you happen to click, it will copy that coordinate. Okay. And as you move around down here, you will see the coordinate come up right here as you move throughout the extent. All right, so I can click anywhere in this extent and it is going to automatically copy the coordinate to my clipboard. So let's say if I press here and it gives me a message, hey, this was copied to your clipboard. And how do I know that it was copied to my clipboard? Well, if I go to my notepad and I paste, there is my coordinate. All right, so let's continue on to the next one. The next thing is the show in external map. Now this is so useful when you need to go directly to mapping software such as Google or OpenStreet or whatever external map package that you like to use. But before I click in the extent, let me show you how to change what map package that you're going to get here. Now, there are several options that are not in the toolbar. This is the Lat Lon Tools toolbar. And to get this on here, you just right-click anywhere on the toolbar and select Lat Lon Tools toolbar. And you see mine is gone. And let's bring it back. Lat Lon Tools toolbar. Now, some things are not here. To get to the rest of the options that this gives, we need to go to plugins, scroll down to Lat Lon Tools, and we'll go to settings. All right. So once we get to settings, let's go to external map. Now the external map is the current button that I'm on. And to manipulate what external map we'll use, we can use OpenStreetMaps. We can drop this down. We can use Google Maps, Google Aerial, Bing Maps, whatever package that you like. Okay, and let me scroll down a little bit. Okay, that's all of them. And you can also determine if there will be a place mark placed on your map for the specific coordinate that you clicked. So let's say if you don't want a place mark, I'll uncheck both of these. And let me go ahead and press OK to save that. So I uncheck both of these, and what these do is basically on the map, on the link that it follows, it will show a place mark if this is checked, and on QGIS map or this canvas back here, it will show a marker where that coordinate is. Now I have both of these unchecked, so it's not going to show a place mark in any, it's just going to show a general location. So if I hit OK And then I go anywhere on this map and I click. It's going to take me out to my, what did I have it set as? Open street map? Yeah, I don't think I changed it. Unless I changed it by accident. And as you can see here, we have a general location on our open street map, okay? But for the most part, a general location is good, but what about the pinpoint of my click? That's what I want to see. So I'll exit this, and I'll go back to my settings, or my plugin settings, Lat Lon tools, to my settings. And now I want to see a place mark on that map, or on the map that the link leads me to, and on my QGIS map. So I'll hit OK. And I can click anywhere on this map. Okay. Now we can see that there is a place mark here because I checked those two boxes. So there's a place mark on my link, and there's a place mark on my QGIS where I click. So the next one is the zoom to coordinate. So what in the world does that mean? All right. So, and I just removed that little marker. All you have to do is press the button again and it'll remove the marker. All right, but we're going to zoom to coordinate. Now, let's go ahead and click that. It'll bring up this little sidebar. It says enter latitude and longitude. So let's say if you have a coordinate, maybe on a sheet of paper or something, and you want to enter it into this box. Now remember, earlier I saved a coordinate to my notepad. So let's go ahead and copy that coordinate. And I'll enter it into the box. And all you need to do is press enter. And it'll point out that location on your canvas extent or on your map. If you want to clear that, there's a button to clear it right here, clear marker. Other than pressing enter, you can press zoom to here and it'll also go to it, but you can press enter. Enter's faster to me. The other thing, let's go to the settings here for zoom to coordinate. In the settings, you'll be able to manipulate the CRS, whether you have a custom CRS or you just want to go and look through different CRSs, you never know. Also, you can change the coordinate order. So the standard Google Map order is Y and then X, or Lat and then Lon. Or you can switch it up, and but you will need to change it if you're going to try to use it in Google Maps. So when it says use persistent marker, what does that mean? Well, that just means that the marker will stay there until another coordinate is specified in the box, okay? So that's, it's supported on over all of the formats. Whatever it is, when it places a marker, it's gonna stay there until you enter a new coordinate. The next thing is, if you mess up anything in the Lat Lon settings, remember that you can always restore the defaults. If you have any questions about anything that you saw, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.